Neek, are you pleased? No, not just pleased. Are you very, very pleased with what you're seeing from the Cowboys?
Are you thrilled to death?
Yeah, I mean, I've made it a habit since I've known Jerry Jones or known of Jerry Jones to not believe anything that he says. So, like, I don't know that he feels the way that he's saying, but I think he's saying what he thinks is the right thing to say. I think we have to accept that they are who they are. They're a boom or bust team on offense and defense. So, yeah, there should be some concern if you expect or want some sort of consistency. They don't have that. So, yeah, I'd be concerned if I was Jerry Jones. Although I would say, given what we expected from this team before the season started, they've already overachieved. But now the opportunities are so few and far between in this league. They have to capitalize on this roster that they have right now.
I'm glad you brought that up. And I know we have fun with Jerry, but you're mentioning overachieving versus what we thought earlier this season. But Mike, when you look at Dallas, it always feels like there's a Super Bowl or bust aspect to them. So on that basis, is what you're seeing on the field matching what Jerry is saying and the expectations that are on this franchise?
Not consistently. They're the best team in the NFL when they're healthy. They have the best offense and defense, that combination of the two. My biggest concern is Mike McCarthy's clock management. He cost them the game the other day. It's clock management 101 that you need to have at least one timeout in your back pocket until there's 2 minutes to go in the second and fourth quarter. Even the fact that Matt Prater was out there with Kyle Murray, you still keep one timeout. And when you think about offense, defense, special teams, and clock management, that is a massive concern, because when healthy, this team has as much talent as any team in the NFL this year. But if they don't clean that up, they're not going to get to where they should be able to go this year.
That's key. Maybe they use Week 18 to implement a new system. But Kimberly, I wonder if they play the starters in Week 18 and what they do for that.
Well, that's why I found it interesting that Jerry expects the starters to play, because, again, Jerry's the owner. He's not the coach. And especially when you have a Philly team that has a serious COVID outbreak, guys may come back. They're dealing with their own things. They might decide that they can't start some guys. But when you look at this Cowboys team, what I want to see from them in Week 18 is, can they actually start fast? Something that they didn't do against Arizona. Can they stop the run? Can, as Mike Tannenbaum mentioned, can we go into next week's shows not talking about Mike McCarthy's terrible game management, his clock management, his decision making? Like, that would be great if we could just not talk about the Cowboys being a disappointment because of how loaded they are. When they are playing at their best, they are the best team in the NFL, if next to the Packers, right?
Yeah.
They are one of the best teams, but we keep talking about them as though they're not meeting expectations. So as much as they are better than they were last year, you still see failed expectations. And that, I don't know how Jerry can look at that and say, I am thrilled, maybe not to death, but I'm ecstatic.
But you make me think, and going back to Mike's point, the clock management part. Neek, the team has obviously been struggling in a couple different ways. They're lacking in consistency, as you mentioned. But the last thing you want is your head coach putting you in bad situations at the end of games. What do they need to do to right that ship at this point?
I don't know. It's been a wayward ship for quite some time. I don't think it's going to get right. I think this is who Mike McCarthy has become as a coach. And I do think that, well, to Kimberly's first point, Jerry Jones is not the coach of this team, but he kind of is whatever he wants to be in that organization. So he can make the decisions that he wants to make. But back to the clock management stuff, it's really unfortunate, because the issue that they had last week, it's one that I guess we could consider excusable. Like, every team I played for, we practiced for situations like this. Like, we had veterans who knew what decisions to make when there were these type of weird substitution things. We should give some credit to Kingsbury for the decision that he made to put them in that situation. But the reason why I am upset with what happened last week is because it's a sign of several things that had happened before. Like, if this was a one-off incident, I'd be more prone to say, okay, Mike McCarthy, that's fine, they got you this time. But it's not. They've been having these warning signs since the beginning of the season. I'd love to see them address it and fix it, but I don't think there's much to fix. I think this is how Mike McCarthy, this is kind of his philosophy. These are the way he makes decisions, and it's unfortunate. It could hurt them. It hurt him last week. It could hurt him again in the playoffs.
Yeah, can you imagine against teams like that? If you can't write that now,
Mike Tannenbaum would be ticked off, so ticked off.
We just go by what we see, and if you don't like the result, fix the process. Yeah. Fix the process now so they have a chance to win.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.